Oh hi guys, it's Apollo here, and with Bannerlord right around the corner, there's a lot of excitement in the air. So what I wanted to do for the next couple months until Bannerlord comes out, I just wanted to occasionally showcase some really awesome community events. The cool thing about Mountain Blade is that it's very sandboxy, not only with single player, but also with the multiplayer. People can get really creative with multiplayer and make some awesome events and awesome game modes. And you know, you have the competitive mode, you have leagues where you have these competitive teams playing in tournaments, and then you have like big organized siege battles. And you know, I'm gonna do a shameless plug here, but I help run a huge siege focused event called Call to Arms. This is where we all get on and we kill each other in big siege battles. It's good fun, it's not too serious. It's pretty lighthearted in these battles, and it's kind of built this community over time. There's links to that down below. We do it pretty much every weekend, so definitely check that out. But today's video is not about Call to Arms, and this is a video for anyone who does like big juicy siege battles. Alright, this video is certainly for you. So, for today's video, we are looking at the community event known as the Cowraetic Campaign. This not only focuses on huge siege battles and field battles, but there's actually an ongoing campaign as well that all the players are involved with. So, essentially, what happens here is that you, the player, will join and sign up for a faction. We'll explain how you can do that later, but you sign up with a faction and you fight for that faction. Now, these factions will go to war against each other, and you're essentially just fighting for territory. And this map right here shows the current state of the Cowraetic campaign. So this has been going on a little bit before Call to Arms. So they started way back in 2016, and it's still going strong, which I just think is fantastic. I just really like this idea because you're putting meaning behind the battles. Like, there's a purpose for the battles, whether you're trying to conquer territory or you're trying to defend your territory. It just puts a lot of story, excitement, and lore and just immersion behind these events. And it makes players fight for something, which I think is just really fun and very exciting for players who are involved with this community, you know, driven event. And clearly the players are really excited about these battles, because if you look at this page right here, which by the way is linked down below so you can view it with me as this video goes on, you have all the information you need. It's a Cowraetic campaign starter guide. I'll paraphrase some of the information here during the video, so if you're too lazy to read it or something, whatever, I'll do that. But I just wanted to point out that if you scroll down, they have the story so far section, and basically look how long this is. They have a huge just page of information about previous battles, the lore, who's killing who, why. It's just really awesome. It's really cool. And that's the kind of stuff I love to see in Mountain Blade. That's the kind of stuff that I think that makes Mountain Blade so special, is just this story. The story behind it, like the opportunity to make a story with the tools that you have. You know, how sandbox Mountain Blade is. So that is just really awesome. And then of course down here you have your rulers. So if you want to get to know your rulers. And then they also have previous events. Event threads, so you can look at like all the events and how they, you know, played out and everything. So pretty awesome stuff right there. So if you like the idea of these events and you want to get involved, I will tell you how. It's really simple. In fact, I even signed up myself. So what you want to do is go to their Discord. Again, it's linked on the page, but it's also linked in the video description. Once you join that Discord, you want to assign yourself to your favorite faction in Mountain Blade. Again, make sure this is a faction you really enjoy, because it is difficult to change factions. You can, but you have to get an admin involved. And you don't want to give the admins any headaches, you know. Just pick a faction and be happy about it, alright? Once you have your faction, you're pretty much good to go. You are part of that army and you're ready to fight for your glorious faction. Now for the events, the actual battles, they have events once a month. And it's the first Saturday of every month. So this is not something that's going to take a lot of time. This is not something that you have to show up to all the time, like every weekend or two times a week or whatever. Just simply once a month, you get on, you have some fun, and it's really, really simple, guys. So once you're a part of the Discord, once you assign yourself to a faction and you want to start playing in the battles, once the event has been announced, again, it's always the first Saturday of the month. It is on their server called Calraded Campaign, and the password is Reddit, okay? So that's simple. Once you're in and you're ready to fight. And these are big 200 player battles, which I just think is awesome. And the way it works, so let me explain a little bit on how you gain territory or you lose territory. So when two factions are fighting each other, they both have the potential of taking territory. So what happens is that they start off with a field battle. Whoever wins the field battle, so let's just have a quick example. Let's say Nords versus Roduk. Let's say the Roduk win the field battle. Well, that would mean that they would be attacking the Nords. So they are the attackers in the siege battle, and the Nords are defending. And again, vice versa. If the Nords won, then the Nords would be attacking the Roduk, and the Roduk would be on the defense. If the attackers win the siege battle, then that's a victory for their faction and they gain some territory. If the defenders win the siege battle, then it's basically a draw and nobody loses anything. So they're kind of fighting to keep that settlement, that territory. And again, once you lose territory, they will change the map right here accordingly, so it shows the growth of your favorite kingdom, your favorite faction. And honestly, guys, that's pretty much it in a nutshell. There is some more minor details, but I think I covered the most important stuff. All I have to say is if you're going to be a part of this, just join, have fun, don't take it too seriously, don't cause any trouble for them. People just want to get in, you know, have fun, kill each other, and log off. You know, they don't want any drama or anything like that. They do have a Patreon, which you can support, and again, I highly recommend if you got a couple bucks, you can throw it their way. This Patreon will be for basically just buying the server and making sure they can continue to afford it. These servers are not cheap, and Patreon kind of helps with that. So if you got a buck or two, throw it their way, and it will go a great distance for them. And I'm sure they're going to need the money for when Bannerlord comes out. And again, I don't know if I mentioned this yet, but they probably, most likely, are going to transfer this into Bannerlord, which, I cannot wait for that. The siege battles in Bannerlord look so good, and it's going to be awesome. And big battles. It's going to be so great. So yeah, their Patreon is linked down below. And I just wanted to end this video with a little bit of just a closing statement, a little bit of appreciation towards these guys, because they've kind of inspired me to do something similar for Call to Arms. And again, I don't want to talk a ton about Call to Arms here, but this is just more my way of thanking them and, you know, with this idea and kind of inspiring me. So with Call to Arms, we are currently working on a campaign as well. It's going to be a fictional place. It's not going to be Calradia, because with Call to Arms, it's kind of like, you know, pixelated Apollo, Knights of Apollo versus Lionheart and Lionheart's Legion. So our subs killing each other. So it's kind of like a fictional world. So we're going to make up a fictional map with cities, and we're going to name the cities based off whatever we want to name them. And we're going to have a similar system. It's going to be a little bit different, but again, I really like this, and it's going to put reasons behind the battle and things we're fighting for, you know, and it's going to have this ongoing campaign map. So I love that idea. I love this Calraded campaign. I'm gonna be a part of it. I'm sorry I don't have any footage of the event. I just missed an event, and I'm gonna have to wait until next month. But once I'm in there, I'm gonna be sure to join it, and I'm gonna be sure to fight hard for my favorite faction. I'm not gonna tell you which one it is, because I don't want you guys to all join me or anything like that. Pick your favorite. I'm gonna be there on the battlefield fighting, and I'm gonna be sure to record it. Maybe go spectator mode and just watch the battle from a spectator point of view, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. So look out for that video in the near future. Again, guys, all the links are down in the video description. This is a really cool event. Something that I think is really special, really awesome. So thank you guys for the time. Thank you so much for taking time to listen to this and being a part of the Mountain Blade community, which I think is an awesome community, an underrated community, and I only want to see it grow. So again, links in the description. Join it, guys. Take part in it. It's going to be awesome. But yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time on the battlefield.